Every time you're with me, you know I'm in a state of bliss.
Trying to find the night. Conversation, laughter, debauchery. Then morning. And I realize it's all just a search for connection. It would be easy to do a story on coffee with pretty, steamy, milky images. I just sit languidly in a cafe sipping. Oh, so romantic. But on the original fare, my job is to get my hands dirty. Because how the f*** else do you understand the real story behind the world's number two commodity? So let's get on a plane to Colombia and go harvest some beans.
I'm trying to get my camera to work. It's our very first coffee tree I've ever seen. Not hard to spot, considering we've been here for like 10 minutes and they're everywhere.
My guides on this adventure are Gary and Carolina. Gary is a coffee buyer for H.C. Valentine, the small batch coffee offshoot of the century-old Royal Cup Coffee based in Alabama. Gary connected us to Carolina, who represents the legendary Juan Valdez Coffee Federation. You know, this guy.
Juan Valdez. He picks the Colombian coffee bean as it has been picked for centuries, by hand, day after day.
We are kind of being pampered right now. We have a driver, we have a van, we have Carolina, who knows everything and the culture. We have you, who's our connoisseur of coffee.
May we?
And then just little old us.
So let me ask you this. Normally, do you just pick a subject and then go create your thing?
Mm-hmm.
So this is really a cool thing that you're actually getting paid for this.
Yeah, somehow I pay rent.
Colombia. It is its heart and its center. People don't just grow coffee, they worship it.
Who's driving me? I don't have a license.
Our adventure begins in the tiny coffee town of Salento, where these little jeeps, called Willys, used to bring the beans to the town center for buying and export after harvest. But now, these little gems can make you coffee.
You could be the new ruler of your hipster city if you had this little open-air jeep that went around making coffee.
So I guess we need to order something.
Yes. Give me your critique.
There's more acidity to this.
You haven't tried it.
Merci beaucoup.
Wrong country.
And also one of the reasons why Colombian coffee has high acidity is that we are on volcanic soils. And usually those minerals result in higher acidity for Colombian coffee.
Interesting. This is genius.
I'm in Colombia to actually get my hands dirty and harvest coffee, but first I'm going to get a lesson from the pros at one of the largest coffee farms in the area at Hacienda Venecia.
No, sir, we're not
there. Está haciendo mucho calor. Tenemos la temperatura
poco,
pero sin embargo,
sí.
Pueden ir.
Sí,
ir, ir,
no,
ir.
Pero hasta mejor para mostrar lo duro que es esta vaina.
No, es duro.
Oh.
Sí.
But you look
¿de
from
qué
the
país?
Huh? I look like what?
From the Netherlands.
From the Netherlands.
¿De dónde?
De Estados Unidos.
Ah, yeah. Estados Unidos. Ah,
this
yeah.
Is the blonde.
Ah, sí, sí.
El Rolo is from Bogotá.
Rolo?
So,
Hello, hi, how are you?
Ay, qué bonito.
Bien.
Bien, you.
Café de Colombia. Bonita, bonito manicure, ¿cierto?
How did you find the job picking coffee beans?
No tenía nada que hacer en Bogotá, estaba aburrido. Okay. Entonces un amigo dijo porque es que yo fui militar 11 años. Entonces a mí me dijeron que se cogía café, yo estos árboles ni los conocía. Mm. Y dijo, vámonos por allá, y yo me vine y aquí estoy.
This is the one he has to work on. Okay, let's see how fast he is. Yeah. He's gonna be so fast. They're going to call the girl. How heavy is that right now?
3 to 4 kilograms.
Recogiendo café?
Como 3 años.
For 3 years she has been...
For 3 years.
They are saying that she picks a lot of beans, but then she has to come all the way up to the mountain with them, and she's so beautiful that she just looks at them and says like, oh, can you please help me, all flirtatious. And all of them think they are, she's flirting with them, but she only wants
she's
to help.
Smart.
Right, smart.
She's a woman.
She's a woman.
I could hang out with them all day. They have so much fun together. Are you sure that this is safe? Well, not that that bothers me, but I don't like throwing up.
Sweet.
Oh, that's very cherry-like. Why don't we use this stuff for something?
Some do.
Really?
And there's a thought behind it.
So you have to be able to work on a steep hill in dense brush and some brutal heat while carrying a heavy bucket. Piece of cake, right?
I think more than 86% of Colombian coffee plantations have less than 5 hectares.
Really?
Yes.
So you find more small farms.
Exactly.
There's only a few big farms.
Yes.
The trees, there's no alignment of them. They're just, wherever there's space, they have a tree.
That's true.
Food glorious.
Thank you for this. Our first Colombian meal is ajiaco, a traditional stew made with chicken thighs, corn on the cob, yuca, and regional herb, guascas. Watching everybody work so hard really works up an appetite.
So, this is a gift from Hacienda Venecia for you guys.
Hacienda Venecia, this is after lunch.
Carolina, there is no time for napping because it's our first night in Colombia.
Oh, great. What is the benefit of laying down hearts?
Cheers.
I'm making a video.
At night in Colombia, the party begins.
She says it's 4, I think it's 5.
Cinco. Quinta. You can have the
cheers. Eyes. Cheers.
Cards are dealt, the rum comes out. The music kicks in, and everyone is welcome to the dance floor. Up next, I get my hands dirty and my mind blown harvesting beans in Colombia. For more adventures in food, subscribe to our channel.